When I go to a movie like this, I go to it with expectations. I go into it expecting that it is a completely different approach from the original story. I go into it expecting parts with action, sad parts, mysterious parts, parts with tension, maybe a little bit of scary parts, like parts that make me laugh. But I also expect that it remains loyal to its source material. Because if it doesn't, then it might as well have a completely different name. And this movie This movie did exactly what I expected of it. Wow, did I enjoy this movie? I was thrilled with the small action parts. There wasn't a lot of action in it, but the action it had was great for a movie like this. I was. Yeah, there were some kind of scary parts in it. I mean, the dark forest was scary-like. There were sad parts in it. Oh god, there were sad parts in it. I come back to that later. There were human parts in it. I laughed like shit. So yeah, it was a great movie. It did remain loyal to its source material. I did recognize the story of Snow White in it in a really adult way. And I really liked that of the movie. Thank God in 2D. That's worth an applause on its own, because all movies nowadays all big movies nowadays are all doing 3D. And for a movie like Snow White to say, fuck it, we're doing 2D for once. Yeah, I really thought it was great. For a movie to do that someday for once. Okay, that's spoilers, by the way. So the movie starts with Snow White as a young girl, and first it starts with Snow White's mother, and it's kind of told the legend of Snow White, that where the mother really wishes a daughter that's really, really beautiful and really, really strong, like the rose she sees in the winter that still survives, and she gets that. Sorry. She gets that daughter, but that daughter dies, and then actually the army of the queen comes in, and well, to all sorts of twists and turns, She seduces the queen, seduces the king, and after she marries him, she kills him and becomes the queen. And she locks Snow White up in the tower. And she escapes with help of birds. Well, you know, birds help her help Snow White escape. And from there, and that was the part of the movie, actually, until she ran off and ended up in the dark forest. More like until the part where she ran off with the huntsman was a little bit boring in my opinion. I wasn't really into the movie until that point, where an hilarious play of the huntsman was performed. I mean, he gave away some funny shit. Oh yeah, rape scene. Oh, it was rape scene. That was nice. Oh well, you know, it in a way that it's fitted in the movie. And when Snow White was still imprisoned, the brother of the key of the queen kind of tries to sexually assault her, and he fails, and it kind of helped portray the brother of the queen, but it also showed that it also helped the story get along, so to give her a way of escaping. And don't get me wrong, I don't meant nice because it was rape, but I meant that it was nice because it really fitted in the story well. It was a risky move, but they didn't went too far with it, and they did it in a way, and they positioned it in a way that it was okay. Oh, and I did. That's me. Lord of the Rings fan, and I did see, and I could swear I could see a Nazgul flashing by when Snow White was running off into the woods. So yeah, and after that, the movie just grabbed me by his throat and dragged me along, and I really enjoyed it. Like I said, the huntsman was great. The part in the village with the woman that scarred themselves to make sure the queen wouldn't go after them. That they showed how far the brother would go for her sister to capture Snow White was wow. And then they met the dwarves, which were hilarious. But they weren't funny to be funny. They had funny bits. They're dwarves. They should be funny. They should have humor. But it wasn't like, oh, they're dwarves, so they, you know what I mean. They didn't went over the top with it. And they played a song with the dwarves play a little song and dance with Snow White. One dance with Snow White. Get kind of a little quick character development between the two of them, real quickly. To create a bond between one dwarf and Snow White, because not long after that, and this is really a spoiler, one of the dwarves gets killed, and it was done in such a good way, and the whole death scene and everything around it, and you felt involved with that dwarf so fast that I'm not afraid to say that that scene and the cremation of the scene and the songs the dwarves were singing, it made me cry. It really made me cry. I had to be careful a little bit because, okay, first I have to tell this. There were 9 people in the whole room. The whole movie room, 9 people. And there were people going to sit right next to me. I mean literally next to me. And if it were nice women of my own age, I wouldn't mind it as much, but it were young girls of 16, 17. So it was like, oh no, and they were quietly talking and eating the snacks, and I was in with the sad scene. I can cry with these teenagers next to me. And I kept it a little bit inside of me because I wouldn't want those teenagers to think, but oh look, there's that creepy, funny walking guy crying there. But it was a sad scene that kind of made me cry, and the whole song around it. And but not long after that, they drag you right into a laughter again. They play with your emotions in a good way. They do. The action was great. The graphic was great. There was some CGI in it, but they kind of mixed CGI with practical effects, which made the CGI okay. It didn't make it that bad. What else to tell about this movie? Oh yeah, what I couldn't get, maybe I missed why, that the queen sent the huntsman because she didn't have power in the dark forest. And it was made clear that Snow White did had some power in the dark forest because there was a troll that didn't want to attack her when he had the chance. But it never became clear to me as why the queen didn't have any power in the dark forest. I just couldn't get it. The elf in place was nice. The whole known thing of with the poison apple was done really, really great, because they went a slightly different direction from the fairy tale we know. And it surprised me. They surprised me with that. So that's nice. They also surprised me at how Snow White got revived. And yeah, it was overall a good and fun experience. And I definitely do recommend going to see this yourself. The trailers I saw just two trailers. The Dark Knight, definitely going to see that. And some cop movie where I already lost the title of. But I do think that I want to see that movie as well. Even though it's only released the end of September. So, that was my little rambling about Snow White and the Huntsman. By all means, if you have the chance... Oh god, I can still get a drink. Beer bottle in front of the camera. What I was thinking of my previous movie. But... anyway, by all means, go see it, and see you next time. Probably on an onion, other than tries. Hey, goodbye, guys.